Should I take iron every day or should I use alternate day dosing? Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind or a substitute therefor. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode. Okay, Heather Chandler asks, based on this preprint study, I have no idea if I've looked at this, so I'll click it open just in case, and I'll make sure to include a link to the study that we're discussing in the show notes of this episode. So based on this preprint study called Iron Absorption from Supplements is Greater with Alternate Day Than with Consecutive Day Dosing in Iron Deficient Anemic Women, Heather has started taking supplemental iron every other day. She continues, that study suggests higher absorption with every other day dosing because iron supplementation acutely upregulates hepcidin for 24 hours. Can you explain the relationship between hepcidin and zinc? And would you expect every other day dosing might increase zinc absorption also? How many minerals are impacted by hepcidin? All right. I don't know if I can even answer this question, but let me take a look at this study. So according to this abstract, in iron-depleted women without anemia, oral iron supplements induce an increase in serum hepcidin that persists for 24 hours, decreasing iron absorption from supplements given later on the same or next day. Consequently, iron absorption from supplements is highest if iron is given on alternate days. Whether this dosing schedule is also beneficial in women with iron deficiency anemia given high-dose iron supplements is uncertain. The primary objective of this study was to assess whether in women with iron deficiency anemia, alternate day administration of 100 and 200 milligrams of iron increases, that's a very big dose of iron, increases iron absorption compared to consecutive day iron administration. So right away, what the language that they're using is suspicious. So I want to see whether the fractional absorption of iron is increased, but whether the total amount of iron is any higher. So I'll be looking for that as I look further. So secondary objectives were to correlate iron absorption with serum hepcidin and iron status parameters. We performed a crossover iron absorption study in women with iron deficiency anemia. There were 19 women who received the doses that they just mentioned of ferrous sulfate, which I wouldn't want to take, and blah, blah, blah. Okay, iron absorption on days 2 and 3 and day 5, days 2 and 3 for consecutive dosing and day 5 for alternate dosing. And so on day 5 with alternate dosing would be at, you know, after there were 2 or 3 doses, or 2 doses, I guess, was measured by measuring erythrocyte isotope incorporation. For both doses, serum hepcidin was higher on day 3 than on day 2 or day 5, but no significant difference between days 2 and 5. Similarly, for both doses, fractional iron absorption, right, which is the thing that I'm not interested in, on days 2 and 5 was 40 to 50% higher than on day 3. While absorption on day 2 did not differ significantly from day 5, there was no significant difference on the incidence of gastrointestinal side effects comparing the 2 iron doses. Alternate day dosing of oral iron supplements in anemic women may be preferable because it sharply increases fractional iron absorption. In order to provide the same total amount of iron with alternate day dosing, twice the daily target should be given on alternate days, as total iron absorption from a single dose of 200 milligrams given on alternate days was approximately twice that from 100 milligrams given on consecutive days. Even if in iron deficiency anemia, hepatic hepcidin expression is strongly suppressed by iron deficiency and erythropoietic drive, the intake of oral iron supplements leads to an acute hepcidin increase for 24 hours. Okay, so I get the logic. I'm just... it takes me a while, especially when only looking at text, to really assimilate stuff like this. My question is whether, so what they're saying is hepcidin is a negative feedback loop for iron absorption. So if you have increasing iron status, or what this is showing is if you just have a bolus dose of iron coming in, you're going to get a hepcidin response that is going to decrease iron absorption. And that short-term boost in hepcidin lasts 24 hours. So the logic is you have a big bolus dose when the hepcidin is not elevated. That produces a negative feedback loop lasting 24 hours. So why dose yourself while that negative feedback loop is strong when you could wait until the negative feedback loop is over and then dose yourself again? I am exceedingly skeptical that this makes any sense in the long term, because first of all, this negative feedback loop isn't just controlled by bolus dosing of iron. It's also controlled by iron status. And so this is actually a very exquisite system for basically ensuring that unless you have a malfunction in the system, as do 8% of the world's population with hemochromatosis genes, possibly higher than that, depending on which ones you count towards this. I believe it's 8% total for all the different alleles in it. I'd have to double check that later. So unless you have an impairment in the system, or you have iron intake that just no matter how much absorption you can extract out of the system is just not enough to prevent or reverse anemia, unless you're in those areas, basically everyone should just have normal iron status no matter how much iron they're eating. That's the logic of the hepcidin system. Now, it may be the case that you get a 24-hour spike that goes away after 24 hours. But let's say you start getting better iron absorption because you're practicing alternate day iron dosing. They only measured this two doses out. So what happens after, maybe on the third, fourth, and fifth dosing, you actually have better total iron absorption. But then as iron status improves, more hepcidin kicks in anyway. And so, what are the chances that this is going to be indefinitely extended out to the 10th, 20th, 40th, 50th dose of iron? It seems that the maximal, unless this is actually tested out that length of dosing, it seems that the maximal benefit of this would be that you might reverse anemia a little bit more quickly. But I question how frequently it actually is the primary concern to reverse anemia in to get a certain incremental increase in anemia reversal in 4 days versus seven. I just feel like this is probably something that's going to kind of wash out in the long term. That said, I do want to look at the data. Because I'm still confused whether there's a net benefit. Fractional iron absorption was about 30. Let's see, individual fractional iron absorption from oral iron supplements taken on consecutive day three and alternate days, day five. Okay, so for 100 milligram iron dose, on the second dose, you've declined from, this is individual people, they don't show the mean. So it looks like you're declining from, say, 30%-ish to maybe 20%-ish on the second dose of consecutive day iron supplementation with 100 milligrams. With 200 milligrams, you're going from maybe 25%-ish to 10%-ish on consecutive day fractional absorption. But if you alternate and you have 100 milligrams, you're staying around maybe 30%-ish or even less than that, 25%-ish for the median, probably about 25%, instead of like 20%. This is a real mess. So one thing that I'm not sure how to screen share this. One thing is that these responses between the different people are exceedingly variable with the 100 milligram dose, and they get less variable with the 200 milligram dose as everything basically gets pushed down towards a minimum of 8% absorption and a median of around 15% absorption when taken every day. And on when taken every other day, you do have some people who retain, like there was one person who retained 40% fractional absorption, but the majority of the people are having their absorption pushed almost down as much as with the consecutive day dosing because of the high dose. So the median here is probably somewhere around 15%. And it's not that much different for the day three. So their logic is that because consecutive dosing pushes down the fractional absorption is what percentage of that one dose did you absorb? Then you should take it every other day, but double the dose. But doubling the dosing for most of the people, not for everyone, but for everyone except three of the people in here, basically, doubling the dose up to 200 milligrams, even on every other day dosing, substantially reduced fractional absorption down to the point where, the median fractional absorption has been pushed down to like 15%. So to me, that strongly reinforces what I was saying at the beginning, which is, you know, even when I was halfway through the abstract, I had the feeling that they're going to be looking at fractional absorption, and I'm very skeptical that they actually had a sound conclusion about total absorption over time. But then after looking at this data, it looks like, you know, there are probably some people who are going to get a net quicker repletion of iron absorption on that protocol. But in the majority of the people in that study, in the majority of the people in that study, just having double the dose on every other day, by the second of those doses, fractional absorption was pushed down almost as much as it is with everyday dosing. And so they only tested two doses. So what happens after the third, fourth, fifth dose? I want to see the study before I waste my time with alternate day dosing. And, you know, bring this back to a practical level. Is it easier for you to maintain a habit of everyday dosing, or is it easier for you to maintain a habit of every other day dosing? Because I know for myself, by far and away, the easiest thing for me to do is to have a little turntable inside my cabinet of everything I'm going to take in the morning, just take it all. The more complicated things get, the more you need a list or you need an app that reminds you to take it every other day. I wake up in the morning, half the time I'm not going to remember whether I took it the day before or not. So I'm going to have to keep track of that somehow. It's just so much more practical to take something every other day, to take something every day at the same time than it is to try to impose more complicated dosing on it, that I would want to be much more convinced that there is a real effect before I was going to bother with that greater difficulty of sustaining the habit.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount. For the remainder of 2020, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.